Imagine an aircraft that can carry nuclear weapons, fly near the speed of sound, and slip past enemy radar. This is the B-1 Lancer, the U.S. Air Force's legendary supersonic bomber, fast, powerful, and feared around the world. In the 1970s, the U.S. sought a new bomber capable of penetrating Soviet air defenses. The B-1 program was born. The original B-1A was fast, but expensive, canceled by President Carter, then revived by President Reagan. The final result, the B-1B Lancer, cheaper, lower radar signature, and still deadly. The B-1 features variable sweep wings, a rare and advanced design. Its wings sweep back for high-speed flight and extend forward for takeoff and low-speed maneuvers. This flexibility allows it to adapt to different combat missions, a huge advantage over fixed-wing bombers. For General Electric F-101 engines, produce 120,000 pounds of thrust. While not as stealthy as the B-2, the B-1B was built for low radar visibility and terrain following flight. It can fly below radar coverage, making it ideal for precision strikes in hostile territory. The B-1 has dropped thousands of bombs across Iraq, Afghanistan, and Syria. During Operation Enduring Freedom, a single B-1B flew a 10-hour mission and destroyed multiple Taliban targets with GPS-guided bombs. This bomber isn't just intimidating, it's battle-tested and highly effective. The B-1 can carry over 75,000 pounds of weapons, the largest payload of any U.S. bomber. Though stripped of its nuclear role for treaty compliance, it now specializes in conventional warfare, delivering JDA MIS and long-range missiles with deadly precision. It's faster than the B-52, carries more weapons than the B-2, and is more versatile than both. Compared to Russia's Tu-160 and China's H-6N, the B-1B has the clear advantage in operational experience and real combat usage. On today's battlefield, it remains unmatched in its class. Though decades old, the B-1B is still being upgraded. Ongoing sustainment programs are modernizing its avionics, sensors, and weapon systems. Even as the B-21 Raider prepares to take its place, the B-1 will remain in service until at least 2036. The B-1 Lancer is living proof that speed, firepower, and adaptability can coexist in a single airframe. It's not just a bomber, it's a statement of U.S. air dominance. And while it may not be stealthy like the B-2 or futuristic like the B-21, the B-1 is the one that shows up, ready to strike. The B-1 Lancer isn't just a bomber, it's a global signal. Every time it's deployed, the world takes notice, and America's adversaries prepare for the worst. In the Middle East, the presence of a B-1 often signals that the United States is considering serious military action. This aircraft doesn't just show up, it arrives when precision and power are needed most. In the Asia-Pacific region, B-1s routinely conduct joint exercises with Japan and South Korea. The message is clear. America is committed to defending its allies and countering threats from North Korea and regional tension from China. China and Russia fully understand how dangerous the B-1 is. China is accelerating its H-20 stealth bomber project. Russia is reviving its Tu-160 program and modernizing the aging Tu-95 Bear. Yet none of them can match the operational flexibility and active deployment history of the B-1B. Even Russian military analysts admit that a B-1B near their borders triggers immediate alerts and raises the stakes. When the B-1 appears, it doesn't just hit hard, it strikes fear. Enemy combatants know that if the B-1 is flying, something is about to be obliterated. The sound alone, a thunderous roar followed by a sonic boom, shakes the ground. That's why it's called the bone. When it shows up, bones break, metaphorically and literally. China and Russia fully understand how dangerous the B-1 is. China is accelerating its H-20 stealth bomber project. Russia is reviving its Tu-160 program and modernizing the aging Tu-95 Bear. Yet none of them can match the operational flexibility and active deployment history of the B-1B. Even Russian military analysts admit that a B-1B near their borders triggers immediate alerts and raises the stakes. When the B-1 appears, it doesn't just hit hard, it strikes fear. Enemy combatants know that if the B-1 is flying, something is about to be obliterated. The sound alone, a thunderous roar followed by a sonic boom, shakes the ground. That's why it's called the bone. When it shows up, bones break, metaphorically and literally. In today's high-tech battlefield, the B-1 is evolving. New upgrades include digital avionics, enhanced targeting systems using artificial intelligence, and real-time data sharing with drones and command systems. The U.S. Air Force is also exploring hypersonic missile integration, turning the B-1 into a launch platform for the next generation of weapons. Some lawmakers have questioned whether it's still cost-effective in an era of drones and long-range precision weapons. Can an aging bomber really compete with modern alternatives? Still, there's one thing critics can't deny: the B-1 brings unmatched flexibility, power, and psychological dominance to the battlefield. Experts agree, the B-1 may be old, but it's far from obsolete. In the event of a large-scale conflict, especially in the Indo-Pacific, the B-1 will likely be among the first aircraft to strike. From Guam to Diego Garcia, from Qatar to the UK, the B-1 can project force anywhere on Earth in under 24 hours. In a world where timing, power, and precision matter, the B-1 remains a crucial asset. With its supersonic speed, variable sweep wings, unmatched payload, and global strike capabilities, the B-1 Lancer deserves its title, America's most feared supersonic bomber. The B-1 Lancer is more than just a bomber, it's a global symbol of American air power. Every time this aircraft is deployed, the world takes notice, and adversaries prepare. In the Middle East, the presence of the B-1 often signals that Washington is considering a serious military response. The B-1 never appears without reason. It arrives when targets must be destroyed quickly, precisely, and with immense psychological impact. In the Asia-Pacific, the B-1 Lancer routinely conducts joint exercises with Japan and South Korea. The message: America is here to stay and ready to counter threats from North Korea and rising pressure from China. China and Russia fully understand how dangerous the B-1 Lancer is. China is fast-tracking its H-20 stealth bomber program, while Russia continues to upgrade its Tu-160 and even revives the Tu-95 Bear with modern weaponry. Yet neither possesses a bomber as flexible and combat-active as the B-1B. Even Russian defense analysts admit, the moment a B-1 shows up near their border, they're forced to increase alert levels immediately. The B-1's battlefield presence doesn't just bring destruction, it brings fear. Enemies know that when a B-1 arrives, it's not just bases they'll lose, it's morale. The sonic boom from a low-flying B-1 can shake the ground and rattle the soul. That's why they call it the bomb, the one that breaks. Despite being decades old, the B-1 is far from obsolete. Its modernization includes AI-enhanced targeting systems, real-time battlefield communications, and air-to-ground surveillance upgrades. There's even consideration for arming the B-1 with hypersonic missiles, transforming it into one of the fastest and most flexible strike platforms in the U.S. arsenal. But with all its power comes controversy. The B-1's operating costs are high, maintenance is complex. Some units have even shown signs of wing structural fatigue. Some members of Congress and military analysts asked, is the multi-billion dollar investment to keep the B-1 flying still justified, especially when drones and long-range missiles can achieve similar objectives without risking lives? Still, one truth remains: no unmanned system can replicate the psychological dominance and tactical flexibility of a manned war machine like the B-1 in real combat. Military analysts agree, the B-1 may be aging, but it is irreplaceable. In a full-scale conflict, like a potential Indo-Pacific war, the B-1 will still lead as a first-strike platform. With global reach, massive payload capacity, and advanced navigation systems, the B-1 can operate from Guam, Diego Garcia, Qatar, or the UK in mere hours. If war breaks out, the B-1 Lancer will be one of the first to launch, and perhaps the last to return.